In this episode, Spectre of the Gun, the first frontier meets the final frontier. The classic American West set against the infinity of space. This episode was quite different than the usual big message stories for which the series was known. The highly stylized recreation of the famous gunfight at OK Corral and the entire episode had an almost comic book feeling about it. Originally titled The Last Gunfighter, this episode didn't please Leonard Nimoy, who had definite problems with the plot. He felt it was an unrealistic story which contained many character inconsistencies and gratuitous violence. Interestingly, this episode was written by none other than Gene Kuhn. At this point, he had left his staff job at Star Trek and was under contract elsewhere. Since he couldn't legally write for the series as Gene Kuhn anymore, he used his pseudonym Lee Cronin. Now, Spectre of the Gun. By this point in the third season, our production budget had been significantly reduced. Since we didn't have a lot of money to create a complex set, producer Fred Freiberger and Bob Justman came up with a plan to make Spectre of the Gun work. Together with scenic designer Matt Jeffries, they created a surrealistic yet inexpensive set. It ended up working very well. It was a reflection of the fragments of human memory and at the same time, a solution to our money problems. Here, for the first time in the series history, the characters seem to actually have learned something through their previous experiences. Spock looked back at Catspaw, the Squire of Gothos, and the cage. Kirk remembers the bluff from the Corbomite maneuver. He decides to forge ahead while facing a dangerous situation. And that's why he was Captain Kirk.